but not much more. Oil production from the 98/2 well will increase to 45,000 barrels per day very soon, and gas production will also start soon. From the western offshore, ONGC has already floated a tender to get an international technology partner. All international oil and gas majors having an annual revenue above $75 billion have been invited to participate in the international tender. I'll repeat, all international oil and gas majors with an annual revenue of over $75 billion have been invited to participate in the tender. Now you come to green hydrogen, which is one of my favorite areas, and I know many of you share that passion also, along with biofuels. The first green hydrogen plant, 10 megawatts, was commissioned on 27th May 2024, even whilst the elections were over. Now, clearly, because of the code of conduct, we could not make a major this thing on it, but I think it's a great achievement. We did not allow the somewhat extended electoral process to interfere in our work, which meant that MOS and I could not be there on that happy occasion to participate in the inauguration. Of course, at that stage, we didn't even know whether we will be in this ministry or not. But now what I can say is that it's a very big milestone to have a 10 megawatt plant commission. Many of our oil PSUs are in the process of issuance of tender to supply green hydrogen. Green hydrogen station at Kochi has been commissioned for bus plying from Kochi airport. And one of my talking points in the last few interactions with you has been that we are the first country in the world to employ green hydrogen buses. And I am very happy to inform you that 15 of these buses are now plying, 11 in Delhi and 4 in Baroda. So that again, now somebody will turn around and say, ask me what is the viability. You know, when you are at this stage of pioneering, you know, starting a new project, you want to demonstrate that. And as we get into green hydrogen more, the cost will also keep coming down. But I think it's a very good start. I was frankly hoping to do this, but I couldn't talk in the last, how many days was the electoral process? 85 days or so. So 85 days ago, we were hoping to get it done. It was done. Today, I can tell you that 11 of them are applying in Delhi and 4 there. One in Kochi also, two. No, Kochi not yet? BPCL. No, I'm not as. BPCL? Not who is this going to do it?
No, we are just commissioning.
That's what I'm saying. Please encourage. Now you have a minister also from Kerala, so then. The green hydrogen refinery, Panipat, 10 KTA, Mathura, 5 KTA, and Paradeep refinery of 10 KTA plants will be installed by IOC soon. Would you like to tell us something about it, or?
I think after you.
After, okay, good. Refinery and Petchem, BPCL is in an advanced stage to set up greenfield refineries, and GAIL is also planning an ethane cracker unit for petrochemicals. BPCL's Bina refinery is coming up, and Cauvery Basin refinery is also coming up by IOCL at Chennai.
Cauvery Basin.
Okay, now ethanol, which is again one of my favorite stories. I'm very happy to inform you that in the month of May, for a month alone, on a month alone basis, we were able to cross 15% of ethanol blending. As you know, the Honorable Prime Minister had set a target of originally of 20% blending by 2030. Just to give you the historical background, when the Prime Minister assumed responsibility in 2014, at that stage, ethanol blending was about 1.4%. He set a target of 10% blending by November 22. We were able to accomplish that 5 months in advance. And at that stage, we moved the 20% blending target from 2030 to 2025. So I can tell you that on the basis of what I have seen and the basis of the work in progress, I am reasonably confident that the 20% blending target, which was brought forward from 2030 to 2025, will be completed by the 2025 ethanol year. Is that the correct term? Okay.